Good morning. How are you all doing? This is my first time speaking at Hobnob, but I'm looking around the room and I see all the same faces I saw at Neshoba County Fair, except you're clean. That's the only difference. Even Scott is clean. I'm just over 100 days into office as your 42nd state auditor, so what I thought I would do is give you a 100-day report card to talk about some of the things that I hoped that we would be able to get done in the first few months when I was in office, and then where we are on those projects and where we're going from here. So first thing that I wanted to do when I came into office was to take a hard look at our budget and try to figure out if there are ways to save money. And we're doing that right now. So we have taken a look at our travel costs and our commodities costs. Commodities are just the physical things that we buy in the office. And we're trying to cut down on those costs. We have an office in North Mississippi. We're going to let the lease expire on that in December. And we're going to try to find a smaller office space that'll save a little bit of money there. We've got salaries that we have cut back on. So people just inevitably kind of leave the state auditor's office. Folks go and folks come. And so we're trying to save money on new folks when they come in the door. So we're working hard to make sure that we maximize every penny that we have of your money that we're having to spend. Thing number two that I wanted to work on was I wanted to try to make sure that our office was the most transparent state agency in state government. So the way we wanted to start to do that was to build a new section of our website. And you can go to it right now. We've accomplished this goal, so you can check that one off your list. You can go to osa.ms.gov/transparency, and you can see all of our active contracts. You can see all of our RFPs so that you know how we're spending your money. That's important because it's not my money and it's not the state auditor's office money. It's your money, and we want you to know how we're spending it. Thing number three that we have been working on is halfway done right now, so you can put half a check mark. We wanted to audit ourselves as soon as I came into office. So we hold all the state agencies to a standard that's about here. We ask them to meet all the legal requirements for spending money, and we thought it's only fair that we also hold ourselves to that same standard. We meet that same mark. So what we've done is we've gone in to make sure that we're doing things the right way. I've seen a draft of that report. It's got some things that we can do better in it, and we're going to fix those things. What we're going to do is finish up that report, that audit of ourselves, and then we're going to map out a report that will also show how we're going to fix all those things. We're going to staple them together, and then we're going to make that public so everybody can see it. Everybody can see what we're doing to improve the function of our office. Fourth thing that I wanted to work on was cybersecurity. So I told people around the state, I've told you at Neshoba County Fair, that I asked folks in our office, coders and software experts in our office, to try to hack us to see if they could break into our system and find vulnerabilities in our cyber system. They asked me when I first told them that, do you want to try to be hacked too? And I said, yes, of course, I'm no exception, hack me as well. That was probably a huge mistake I'm realizing now, because every few days they try to get into my system, so I have to be aware of what they're trying to do, and they hadn't tricked me yet, but they keep trying. Unfortunately, they have tricked some people in our office, so now everybody in our office, including me, is going through cybersecurity training to try to identify ways that hackers try to get into our system. And what we're going to do at the end of that time is we're going to look back, we're going to see the vulnerabilities in our system, we're going to fix them, and then we're going to take those things that we have learned, and we're going to take them to other state agencies. We've already decided to partner with two or three other smaller state agencies, and we're going to take our information to them and help them figure out how to make their data safer as well, and hopefully by the middle of next year, we'll be working with all our state agencies to make sure that data across state government is a little bit safer. One thing I did not talk a lot about right when I came into office, but it's something that I'm proud of and we have worked hard on, is we have tried to revamp and re-energize our investigations division. If you have not opened up a newspaper in the last 3 or 4 months, you may not know that these folks are doing incredible work right now. And one of the reasons they're able to do incredible work is that I brought in a new director of investigations named Richie McCluskey. Richie is a brilliant, energetic guy. He's got decades of investigations experience in public integrity. He's done mortgage fraud cases. He did financial crimes cases. He's run an investigations division in the AG's office. He most recently was chief of police in Flowood, so he knows what it's like to run a big law enforcement entity. Our folks know that he demands results and I demand results, and they have responded incredibly well to that. You may have heard that our folks, our investigators, announced the largest individual embezzlement demand in the last 5 years, the third largest in the last 20 years in Coahoma County. And I'll tell you, it frustrates me to think about that case sometimes, but the case involved two women who decided to steal nearly $1 million from Coahoma Community College. They did so by taking these government procurement cards and going and spending money at Walmart and spending money at Kroger and spending money at Amazon. And they racked up a bill of nearly $1 million. And that's $1 million that community, that community college, and those students cannot afford to do without. I've had some folks who ask me, why do you go out and talk about all these cases when you finish them? Why is it important for you to discuss what happened in some of these instances? And it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure this out. I want people to know that it's not okay to steal money in Mississippi. And if you do, we're going to be out there watching. And ideally, if we keep talking about it, and I keep talking about it, then it prevents somebody from stealing money in the first place. That's the end goal, is to stop this from happening in the first place so that we never get there. We found innovative ways to partner with some other folks. So I partnered with my friend Drew Snyder at Medicaid, who worked with us, and we found $600,000, over $600,000 of Medicaid money that had gone to pay for the health care of dead folks and folks that shouldn't have otherwise received those payments, and we're working with them to get that money back right now. So those are some of the things that we're doing, working across state government and re-energizing our investigations division to try to get money back for you. I'll tell you this in closing. A year from now, I'm going to stand back in front of you at the same podium, and I'm going to be in the middle of a job interview, and it's going to be a job interview with you. And you're going to have my resume on your desk. And that resume is going to be everything that I've done and our office has done over the last year and a half. And if you like what you've seen and you like the direction of the office, I'll ask you to vote for me for 4 more years in this job. If you don't like it, you can vote for somebody else. But either way, it's going to be pretty crystal clear what my intentions are in this job and where I want to take it. And I'll tell you, if you hadn't figured it out by now, my intention is to be tough. My intention is to be fair, and my intention is to bring every ounce of energy that I possibly can to this job. And doing that, I think we're going to maximize our opportunity to get money back for the taxpayers, to get your money back and put it where it belongs. Thank you so much. It's good to see you. God bless you.